Good morning, dear friends. Today, again we are going to learn the topic verbs. In our previous video, we have learned about the things that is transitive verbs and intransitive verbs. We have learned about this two things. What is transitive verb? Rohan is singing a song. So now here you can see that Rohan is singing a song. So here Rohan is a subject, verb, and a object. When a sentence has got a subject plus verb plus object, or it has got an object, right? So then it becomes a transitive verb. But whereas in the intransitive verb, you will see here, Rohan is singing. So when I told you over here, so it is subject plus verb. There is no object. Correct? So for intransitive verbs, we require an object in order to complete or have a meaning in the sentence. Here in intransitive verbs, we don't require an object to complete the sentence. We are just saying that Rohan is singing. So therefore, it becomes an intransitive verb. So, my dear students, okay, now let us move towards another topic that is called finite verbs and non-finite verbs. So now let us learn finite verbs and non-finite verbs. Now in this you can see here, it is very, very simple in order to understand. So let us take a sentence. She draws a picture. She is the subject, draws a verb, and this is a object. Correct? So here you can see that she draws a picture. Now you can see here the subject is singular. Correct? So verb also is a singular. She saw an elephant. Correct? Again here subject, verb form, past tense and object. So which tense is this? A simple past tense. So depending on the tense also, and when the verb is telling something about the action, therefore it will become a finite verb or finite verb sentence. Correct? So you need to find out whether there is an action taking place or no, and whether there is a tense form of the sentence. Correct? So that is why it is very simple to understand what is finite verbs and okay. With the example, I hope you are very clear. Now let us learn something about non-finite verb. Now non-finite verb means what? Non-finite verb, okay, they will tell us something. Let us see the example. Okay, sleeping in the afternoon is not at all healthy. Sleeping in the afternoon is not healthy at all. So you'll be confused whether it is a verb or whether it is a noun or what. Okay? So what non-finite verb? Okay? Non-finite verb will be having ing, ed form or to form. Correct? So example, sleeping we have written here. Slept or to sleep. Now here let us try to understand what exactly the word sleeping tells us. So sleeping in the afternoon is not healthy at all. Remember this, non-finite verb means there will be noun or there will be adjective and adverb. So it could be noun, it could be adjective and it could be adverb. So now here the word sleeping has become a noun or a subject. Therefore, it becomes a non-finite verb. Here there is no action and there is no mention of the tense. Correct? Simple present tense, past tense or the future tense. You will be saying, sir, it is is given, so it is a present. But here we are trying to tell us it is not a form of a tense. Correct? So therefore, this becomes a non-finite verb. Now let us take another example. Okay. He saw a sleeping cat yesterday. He saw a sleeping cat yesterday. Now in this sentence you can see here there is a subject, there is a verb. So this is an action. He saw a sleeping cat. But what about this verb? Or what about this word? So is it a verb or is it a non-finite? Now, subject, verb, to sing, and an object. Now you can see here, action is there, present tense, but here we have another to sing, correct? When we use here the another verb after the verb, correct? That becomes the finite, or sorry, non-finite verb, correct? So here, so it is acting as an object. Correct? To sing. So that is the thing. Here also a song, that is there another thing. But here you can see that, okay, it could be a noun, it could be adjective, it could be verb, it could be adverb, or it could be an object. So when you understand about non-finite verb, correct, keep it in mind, okay, whether it is a tense or not. Once you understand this, correct? This is the half thing in this tense, correct? But after that, when a verb is having to or ing, okay? Or have the past, could be anything, correct? So therefore, it will become a non-finite verb. Simple thing, finite verb is subject plus verb plus object. That's why it becomes a finite verb. Why? Because it tells something about the tenses as well. Here, the action, but when there is another verb is mentioned in the sentence, okay, which will not tell you about the action, it will tell you about the noun, or it could be adjective, or it could be adverb. So therefore,